Hello and welcome back to Downesy Minecraft Universe. Today's tutorial is another train, but today it's not going to be a tube train. It's going to be just a normal overground train, an electric train, passenger train. This is the kind of train that I find running along the main line going from Liverpool Street to Chingford, which is the main line by me. It's that kind of style. I've done three carriages again. This first carriage is identical to the one at the end. Then we've got the one in the middle is a little bit different. And I'll run you through that when we get to it. This side, I've done the doors closed. Now again, like on the previous tutorial, I haven't used the normal doors because I just aesthetically, they just don't look very good, to be honest. So all I've done, I've just bricked it up and just put a double glass block there just to look like doors, then with the buttons on that side. And when we go on the inside, this side again, like on the other one, I've just if this would be at a train station platform, the doors would be open, so I've just used the glass panels there just to give the look like it's open. Right, so if we just go inside, just to show you the inside. The first time on a tutorial I've used the ender rods. The good thing is using these on the inside as well, I haven't got to put any lights because obviously they light up. So we, oh, I'm missing one there. So we've got the inside as well, which runs, we can go all the way down to the bottom of the train. Right, so what I'll first do, this is again the city texture pack, just in case you're all wondering. What I'll first do, we'll just have a look at the bricks and the different blocks that I'm using. So for the railway itself, I'm just using, it's five across. I just put gravel at the bottom and then I'm using anvils and then the dark oak panels, just to give the sleeper look. So we've got gravel, we've got anvil, and then we've got the dark oak panels, two gravel. And then I've just placed down all the other blocks I'm using. As far as I know, everything else is there. I don't really need to explain to you all what they are, really, but we can just have a little float across. And then you can see everything that we use there. There we go. So you can always pause that and have a look. What I've done already, just to save a bit of time, I've placed down the, oh, that's a block I haven't put down. It's a block of coal. Remember that block of coal for the wheels. The first thing, and I haven't even put it down. Right, so we've got the blocks of coal. I've put those down already. Now, what I've done, just to let you all know, this is the first time I've built this train. So I actually built it here. So now I've got to recreate it, so you'll have to bear with me because, like I said, I've only built this once and that is then. So what I've put down is just these little markers just so I know exactly the spacings. So we'll put a set of wheels there, starting there, and then there's a gap of five, and then we've got two more, gap of nine, two more, gap of five, two more, gap of nine, two more, gap of five, two more, gap of nine, two more, gap of five, two more, gap of nine, two more, gap of five, two more. There's a pattern error if you haven't noticed. Gap of nine, two more, gap of five, two more. So it's literally 5 9 5 9 5 9 5 9. Right, so we will have all together 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 sets of two wheels. So when you put the first two down, it's 5, 9, 5, 9, 5, 9, 5, 9. Remember, they're the gaps. So don't do what I do all the time and count five and then put your block on five, because then that won't be right, it'll be on six. Right, so let's get ready to rumble and we'll start here. Okay, so we'll start with a stone slab. Place one there to start, and one there, and then we'll stick another one there, and we'll flick over to the block of iron. 1, 2, 3. No, I've got that wrong already. Sorry. That's it. That's what I want to do, like that. So we'll put a 3 there, and then we'll go 2, and then we'll have 3 blocks of the iron, and then again we'll go back to the stone slab, we'll go all the way up to the other wheel, and then one past it, and then we'll go 1, 2, 3, and then from there, now how many do we come out? I think we come out, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll go all the way to the other one, and then we'll get to the middle, which will be there, and we'll knock that out. So we've got 4 there and 4 there. Okay, and then what we'll do the same with that. So we'll put a block either side there. We'll go 1 in. We'll do 1, 2, 3. And then we'll do that like that. Then we'll carry that on along. 1 in, 3 blocks of iron, stone slab. And then again, we'll come all the way to the next carriage. And we'll knock that one out there. Did I put one either side there? On the last one? No, I didn't. So we'll stick that there. Again, you'll have to really excuse me. It's, like I say, it's the first time I've built this, so I'm kind of trying to remember as I do it. So we'll go another one there, another one there. One more in. 1, 2, 3. And then we'll take this one all the way. One more in there. 3 more blocks. And then we'll put that at the end, and then all we're going to do now is just take that out. Do we take that out by one? No, we'll do, we do, you know what, I've done this wrong already. I'll tell you what, I have done this wrong. Not to worry. Anyway, we'll go back to the beginning here, and I can see exactly where I've gone wrong. All right, so we'll put 3 there, knock that one out, knock that one out, and then we'll put the hoppers in either side of the wheel. So every wheel will get a hopper every side, and you'll see where I've gone wrong straight away anyway, but it's not an issue. So we'll stick those hoppers in either side. See, that's where I've gone wrong, knock that one out. And then we can put a stone slab either side. Again, same there. Make sure that you, when you do that, you put the hopper so it joins up the actual onto the actual wheel itself, like that. Looking sexy, looking sexy. And again, knock those out, and then we can just add those. Oh, add those back in. Put one more stone slab there, one there, knock those out. Hopper. Like that. And then the last ones. There we go. Voila. That's fantastic. Okay, we'll go back to the stone slab. We'll fill in the middles there. And there. And there. And we'll do that again there. 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 We'll leave those empty. There. And then we'll do the other side. By the way, I didn't say I hope you all had a fantastic Christmas and a lovely new year. I know I did. Right. Okay, so that's all the stone slabs in there. So far we've got the base of the train. And then we'll start. What we'll do, we'll do the front and the back of each train. So we'll concentrate on these sides. Sorry. The front here and then the other side and then we'll fill in the middle. Right, so what we're going to do now, yellow wool, 1, 2, 3, and then we do a 5 like that, another 5 like that, and there we'll go 1, 2, 1, 2. Black stained glass. 1, 2, 3. And then one on the top there. What we're going to do, quartz stair. 1 there. 1 there. Same again on the other side. So we've got something that looks like that. Stone slab. Across the top. What we're going to do, get our stone brick stairs and we can stick one there, one there, one there, and one on there, and then back to the stone slab, one there and one there. So we've got that nice little design. Cobblestone wall, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Just like that. So far, that's what we've got. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to get ourselves item frame, block of gold, and a sign. And then we'll put two of those item frames on either side there. Block of gold for the lights, and then we'll just get the sign, one on there, one on there. So there we have it. That's pretty simple. Now all we're going to do is duplicate that on this side. So we go 1, 2, 3, then we've got a 5, another 5, and 2 twos, black stained glass, 1, 2, 3, one more there, just like that, quartz there, one there, one there, one there, one there, and then stone brick stair, back over to the slab. One there, one there, cobblestone wall, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, item frame, 1, 2, 1, 2, block of gold, and then the sign. Another stone brick slab again, 3 across the top there. So there we go. Now we've got the fronts all sorted. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to get our, there we are, quartz stairs again. And then we're going to get our different walls. So we're going to have lime wool, light grey wool, in this texture pack, the lot grey wool for me is better than the white wool. That's why I use it. Blue wool. Okay. What we're going to do first, let's make sure we're all sorted. Yeah. We're going to go 1, 2. So we've got 2 wool on that wheel there. And then we're going to quartz stairs all the way along. And then we'll go 1 past the wheel, like that. And then we'll go 1, 2. And then 1 more quartz stair on the end, like that. And what we're going to do here, it's going to be pretty much the same again. So we'll start on this one. So we'll have, oh no, sorry, 1 sec. So we've got 2 there, quartz there, like that. And we'll keep the quartz there again, all the way along. Again, 1 past the wheel. 1, 2. And then 1 quartz there on the end there. Right, from there, we'll go with the wool again. So we'll have 2 more wool, 1 quartz there. And then again, the quartz stairs all the way along. Until we get to the wheel, we'll stop at the wheel. And then we'll do 2. So that's what we got. And what we'll do, we'll just copy that on the other side. So just run that all the way along. Same again this side. All the way along. Stop there. 2 wool, 1 more quartz there. Once again, 2 more wool, 1 stair. And then run that one all the way along again. There and 2 wool. So that's what we got so far. Right, what I'm going to do now is get the cyan wool and we're going to, oh no, that's blue. We're going to start filling in the bottom. See there, I'll stop. Can't remember. Tell you what, let's take it to there. Leave that gap. No. No, I don't. That's it. So we'll stop there just before the quartz step. Carry on along. Stop there. Start again there. Okay, and then we'll just quickly fill the rest of that in, just like I've done there. Okay, so I've filled the rest of that in with the wool. So that's what you've got, that effect there. And what I'm going to do is get my stone brick stairs, come to the middle here, and we'll go 1, 2, 1, 2, and then we'll put 1 this way, facing outwards like that, so we get that effect. And the same there. And then we'll just get our stone slab and fill in the middle. And we'll do exactly the same with this one. One's in the middle. Stone slab. 1, 2, 3. Fill that in. So that's what we've got so far. Okay, what we're going to do, get our blue wool, start off 1 there, leave a space of 2, and then we'll work all the way along until we get one block before the wall. We'll leave a space of two, and then we'll go one, two, and then what we'll do, we'll put one there, so we've got a gap. That'll be the door in between each carriage, and we'll repeat the same on this side. So you leave your two, carry on along till we stop there, leave two and put a one there. Okay, we'll go to the next carriage. We'll start this side, that way I can see that side. We'll put one there, and then we'll start there again. So we'll have two, leave a gap of two, and then we'll run all the way along until one before the wall, the green wall, and then we'll leave a gap of two and do the same like that. Now what I'm going to do, just carry on this side. So we'll have another one there. One, two, gap of two. All the way along, and then again, gap of two and put one there. Now all I'm going to do now is just repeat that. Same there, leave a gap for the door. Okay, so that's what we've got so far. All the blue wall. Now what we're going to do, we're going to get our line wall, and we're going to do a two, and then leave one and do another two. We'll do the same there, but we'll have it facing the opposite way. So we'll do a two, leave a space of one and do another two, like that. And we'll do that all the way along. And there we go, so that's what we've got. And then all we're going to do again is mirror that. And then the last one's here. Again, that's what we've got now. So we're going to take our light grey wall, and we're going to go one, two, like that, and then put a block there. So we've got a little L shape. Same again there. One, two. And I'm going to leave a gap of three. One, two, three. One, two. And then, how many is it? Seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Is it eight? That can't be right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Oh, that's right. So it's a gap. See, that's why I get confused. It's a gap of seven. There we go. That's right, the doors. So I need two there. I must apologise for this. Like I say, it's the first time I've built it, so we'll have a two there, and then we'll go two and one. So we've got a little L shape. This time at the back here, we've got a three and then a one. So that's a little bit longer. And then we'll put two there, two there, two there, and then we'll just mirror this. The only difference we're going to do now, we're not going to have the two there. So we'll put two in there, gap of seven, and then one, two. One, two, three. One, two, three. So that's what we've got. Right, let's go back over to this side. Again, one, two, one, two. One, two, and then two more there. Then we're going to go one, two, three. One, two, One, two, and then is that again the same? Let's just count these. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's it. This one, this side's longer, this carriage. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then 1, 2, leave a gap, 1, 2, leave a gap, 1, 2, and 1. And then here, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, leave a gap of 3, 1, 2, and then we'll get another gap of 9, and then 1, 2, leave space of 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 3, and a 1. Okay, so we'll go back to here. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, like that. Leave a gap, 1, 2, leave a gap, 1, 2, and I think this one's a gap of 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 1, 2, leave a gap, 1, 2, leave a gap, 1, 2, 1, and then 1, 2, 3, and then we'll just do the same on the other side. 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, leave a gap of 3, 1, 2, gap of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 1, 2, gap of 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and there we go. So far, so good. Like I say, excuse me when I'm doing the counting because, well, it's me, ain't it? Right, so are we happy with that so far? Good, good, good. Okay, now we're going to grab our quartz stairs. We're going to start from there and we're going to run that all the way along. Stop there, start again there. I mean, you could just run all the way along and then smash them out. I suppose that'd be easier. So we're doing all the way to the end, like that. Then what we're going to do, we're going to come on the inside and start there, so we've got it like that, and just run that along the inside. What we're going to do there, when we get to that bit, we'll stop and just put three wool, carry on with the quartz stairs. We'll stop there. Three wool. Back to the stairs. Same again. Okie doke. Now we're going to go the quartz stairs on this side. Finished with that, we'll go back on the inside and do what we've done on that side and just run one all the way on the inside of that one, like that. Same with this one. Oh, and there we go. So that's what we've got. Right, now what we're going to do, we're going to take black stained glass, pop it there, lime stained glass, pop it there, and we'll get a blue stained glass panel, black stained glass panel. Right, what we're going to do, we'll start off two black, is that right? Yep. and then two lime. So that's the way we're going to have it. So every time we get to the green, we'll put two green in, just one further in, so we've got that gradient line like that. Right, black in there, so two in those, and then run that along. And then we'll switch back to our lime. So we've got two there, like that. And then three more in there. Okay, so three black there, two lime. Two in there, fill that one in. Two in there, lime, two lime. Three black again, two lime, back to black, back to our lime, one, two, and then two black. So that's what we've got. We'll come around this side and we'll do the same again, but we're going to leave these gaps and I'll show you what we're going to do. So we'll go two and two with the black, fill that in, leave that, two lime, three black, two lime, leave that, fill this side in all with black, leave the gap, two lime, three black, two lime, all black, two lime, two black. There we go. Now what we're going to do, take out all this blue wool. Okay, and when we've done that, we'll switch over blue stained glass. We'll go one, two, black, one, two, one, two. So that's what we've got. So we'll do that now for the rest of the carriages. Okay, so I filled the rest of those in. What I'm going to do now is just grab my little button, and then we're going to go either side of the doors and then put one on each side like that. So that's what we've got, and we'll flip back over to this side and do the same again. So remember, these are the closed doors, which is obvious. It's shaping up nicely. We'll have a train finished in no time. It takes so much longer working out the build than it is to build it. The amount of times I've built it and then knocked it down, and then built it and knocked it down. Right, so that's what we've got. And what we're going to do now, we'll go with our stone slab and we're going to fill it in. We'll stop there and then do the same. Actually, before we do that, get our stone brick. What we're doing. That's it, come this side. Is that right? Is that what I'm doing? No. Oh, that's it. So, one in there. One there. Like that. So that's what we've got. And then stick a stone slab in there. Let's just quickly do this one as well. So another stone brick. So on the corner there. That stone slab, and then we'll get cobblestone wall, three there, three there, so that'll join up the carriages. Same again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to fill in the rest of this roof with the stone brick stairs. And when I've done it, I'll get back to you. Okay, so I've filled all that in. That's what we've got. And what we're going to do now is this electrical coupling, conduit, whatever you want to call it. I don't know, which connects the train to the power lines. So what we're going to do, there's no real exact place where you have to put this. So all I've done, I've started at the first, the middle carriage, glass block there. I'm just gone to the fifth one, so that's pretty much the middle. Just knock that one out, knock that one out. What I'm going to do, stone brick stair facing this way. So you've got the stair like that, and then the same again there. Two stone slabs, like so. Right, armor stand, put that one there. Then we're going to get a lever, put it behind, and face it that way. Right, what we're going to do now, cobblestone wall, stick one there, one there, and then we'll get rid of those two. Stone slab, put one at the bottom there, and then one there, so it sits nicely on top of the armor stand. Cobblestone wall, and there we have it. That was a pretty simple one, just like that. And what we're going to do, glass pane, and then we'll run that all the way along. And we'll do the same with this one. If you can come up with a better way of doing a coupling or connector or whatever you want to call it, if you do it and you've got a video or a picture, somehow if you can just let me know, because I'm not overly entirely happy with this one. It looks a bit too bulky, but at the moment it does the job. And if I come up with another one, I'll change it and let you all know. But for now, that's all I've got. Let's just do the end. So that's the train, or the outside of the train, all finished and done. I mean, it's pretty sweet. And when they're next to each other, you've got two next to each other, it looks even better. And it's a pretty sweet build. Right, what we're going to do, we're going to do the inside. So we're going to get dark oak wood stairs. And then we're going to get end rod. We've already got glass pane, so we need painting, and I think we'll need another black stained glass, so we'll stick that there. Now, that's what I need to do. Right, get yourself light grey wall, and then what we're going to do, we're going to leave a gap of one, one, two, one, two, one, two, so we got threes. Like that, and then knock that one out there, knock that one out there, and then we've got fours, and then we'll stick one like that, black stained glass. And then what we're going to do, grab a door, I'll use the iron door, use whichever one you want, stick that there, just like that, painting. And what we want is the black monitor. That one there, just like that. What we'll do, go to each carriage and put a block of glassing, go back to the painting, same again, monitor. I'm not putting any doors in here. This is such a pain doing this. Come on. There we go. Right. Same with this one. And then we'll go to the end of here, light grey wall, leave the gap again, and we'll go 1, 2, 3, knock that one out, stick one there, knock that one out, there we go, black stained glass, iron door, and again, painting, oh, it couldn't be the first time, could it, come on, there we go, and that's what we've got. Then we're going to put some seating in. So what I'm going to do, leave a gap either side of the doors and put some seating in like that. Again, gap either side. Same again, gap either side. And then what we've got here, we've got a 2 on this end carriage. We'll put one in like that. Get your end rods. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now I'll leave that gap there, which is directly in the middle of this carriage. And we're going to put glass pane in. Like that. Might as well put it in on the other side. Now you can replace them again with end rods. I just thought I'd break it up a bit by having those glass panes there. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then we'll just repeat on this side. So it's either space by the doors. That's what we've got in the carriage. That's the first carriage done. Now all you're going to do is do this exactly the same as you did in this one, but on the end carriage, which I won't bother doing because I've just done it. So you can just copy that one. And what we're going to do, this one's a little bit different. Only a little bit. We'll start again. Always leave a gap by the doors. Put in your chairs. Gap. Chair but facing in, so it's like that. Gap by the door, put these ones, this middle carriage, the chairs have to join up in the middle, so we'll have like that. So we've got a gap, so we've got sort of 3 sets of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. But there's no gap there in the middle. And again, we'll excuse me, we'll leave another gap. 1, 2. 1, 2. And then gap. And then we've got a chair facing in. Then what we'll do, we'll just fill all these with end rods. Obviously leave the gap in between the chairs there. Do the same on this side, and then we're pretty much done. And there we have it. That is the train all done. Like I say, if you just fill that end carriage in the same as the front one, exactly the same. And there we have it, our little train. Lovely little build there. Hope you all followed the tutorial. I know my building skills are probably actually better than my tutorial skills. But they're nice looking trains. They are the sort of modern train you see, especially in Britain, running on your overground, you know, local sort of rails, that sort of thing. The next one, hopefully, I'll do a diesel train, freight trains. I'm going to try and get a few trains done because I quite enjoy doing them. They do look good once I've designed them and come up with a good build. So please give me a like, subscribe, whatever. Hopefully, I'll see you again soon. Thank you all for watching, and I love you. Bye.